Hello student, my today's topic is balancing of chemical equation. Okay, so in the previous class we have studied about the types of chemical reaction, and now we move to the next topic, that is balancing of chemical equation. Okay, so let us take one example to learn how to balance a chemical reaction. So now for example, we have when nitrogen react with hydrogen to obtain ammonia. Okay, so now balance the equation. So how to balance? First we have to write LHS on reactant side and RHS on product side. LHS means left hand side means reactant side, and right hand side means product side. So now check which elements is used in LHS. Here nitrogen and hydrogen is present, and here we also have nitrogen and hydrogen. So how many nitrogens we have? 2. And hydrogen? 2. And how many nitrogen we have in RHS? 1. And number of hydrogen is 3. Okay, so we have 2 nitrogen and 2 hydrogen in left hand side, and 1 nitrogen and 3 hydrogen in right hand side. Okay, so now here we have 2 nitrogen, and here we have 1 nitrogen. So it should be multiplied by 2, na? Then the number of nitrogen will become 2, and number of hydrogen 3 to the 6. Okay, so now nitrogen is balanced in LHS and RHS. Number of nitrogen will become 2 for hydrogen. So the number of in LHS we have 2 hydrogen, and in RHS we have 6 hydrogen. So it should be multiplied by 3, na? So the new number of hydrogen will become 6. So now hydrogen is balanced. So here the nitrogen and hydrogen is 2 and 6, and nitrogen and hydrogen is 2 and 6. So this reaction is a balanced chemical equation. Okay, so now we move to the next topic. We have the next example. For example, we have another example. For example, KClO3 convert into KCl and O2 to balance this chemical reaction. Okay, so first you have to write LHS on reactant side and RHS on product side. Now check, here we have potassium, chlorine and oxygen, and in RHS we have potassium, chlorine and oxygen. So in LHS we have 1 potassium, 1 chlorine and 3 oxygen, and in RHS we have 1 potassium, 1 chlorine and 2 oxygen. So now number of potassium and number of chlorine is 1 in LHS, and here also 1, na? So for oxygen, the number of oxygen in LHS is, we have 3 oxygen, and here we have 2 oxygen. So now we take the LCM of 3 and 2. The LCM of 3 and 2 is 2 ones are 2, 3 ones are 3. So the LCM is 2 into 3 means LCM we have 6. So it should be multiplied by 2. Here O is multiplied by 2, and it should be multiplied by 2, 3 is 6, na? So 3. So the new number of oxygen will become 3 to the 6, and number of potassium will become 2, and number of chlorine will become 2. 2 potassium and 2 chlorine and 2, 3 is 6 oxygen. And in RHS we have 1 potassium, 1 chlorine and 3 to the 6 oxygen. So the number of oxygen will become 6. So now oxygen is balanced. Okay, and in LHS we have 2 potassium, and in RHS we have 1 potassium only. So it should be multiplied by 2. So now the number of potassium is balanced, and number of chlorine will become 2 ones are 2. So now we have 2 potassium in LHS and 2 potassium in RHS, and 2 chlorine in LHS and 2 chlorine in RHS. 6 oxygen in LHS and 6 oxygen on RHS. Okay, so now this reaction is a balanced chemical equation. Balanced chemical reaction. Okay, so now we take another example. Okay, so if we have a reaction as when C3H8 or react with oxygen to give carbon dioxide gas and water. So let us balance it in this reaction. So first you have to write LHS on reactant side and RH is on product side. In LHS we have carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, and in RHS we have carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, so number of carbon we have 3 carbon, 8 hydrogen and 2 oxygen, and in RHS we have 1 carbon, 2 hydrogen and 2 oxygen here and 1 here. Number of oxygen is 3. Okay, so now we have 3 carbon in LHS and 1 carbon on RHS. So here should be multiplied by 3. The number of carbon will become 3. Okay, so now carbon is balanced. Okay, and number of oxygen will become 3 to the 6, 1, 7. 6 oxygen are there and 1 is here. So now the number of oxygen will become 7. And for hydrogen, the number of hydrogen we have on LHS, we have 8 hydrogen, and on RHS we have 2 hydrogen, so it should be multiplied by 4. Okay, so the number of hydrogen will become 8, and number of oxygen 3 to the 6 here and 4 on the 4 here, the number of oxygen will become 10. 6 and 4, 10 oxygen we have in on RHS. Okay, but in LHS we have only 2 oxygen, so it should be multiplied by 5. Okay, the number of oxygen become 5 to the 10. So now the number of carbon we have 3 on LHS and 3 on RHS, and the number of hydrogen we have 8 on LHS and 8 on RHS, and number of oxygen we have 10 in on LHS and 10 on RHS. So now this reaction is balanced chemical reaction. Okay, this balancing method is known as heat and trial method. Okay, so this is the heat and trial method for balancing chemical equation. Okay, to use this trick and use this method to balance some another chemical equation. Okay.